Okay, well, Jason Aziz from Concord Hospital joins us today, and we're making a special soup, a really hearty fall soup today in the News 9 kitchen. And I know, Jason, that you're in here for the Cancer Society. They're having looking for volunteers and sponsors for their Daffodil Days, which takes place in March.
That's correct.
Okay. And tell me a little bit about what we're going to be cooking here.
Well, this is a roasted butternut squash bisque sprinkled with toasted pumpkin seeds. Now, I used to make soups all the time, homemade soups. But then I had kids, and that all stopped pretty quick. So I've got a couple of shortcuts I want to share with your viewers to show them how you can have the best of both worlds, have great kids, and still taste wonderful homemade soups. The shortcut here that I'm using today employs this canned, or this is a box, chicken stock, okay? And if you're not into eating animals, you can do vegetable stock, which is what I used for this dish right here. And then I just use this fat-free half and half. You can also use heavy cream, but if you want to make it more healthful, these Simply Smart or fat-free half and half is wonderful. It gives you the creamy texture without all the saturated fat, and that's
a great
improvement.
And what do you have cut up right over here?
This is some butternut squash with red onion that I tossed together with some olive oil, salt and pepper, and some spices like cinnamon, ginger, and nutmeg. This is a version here that's what it looks like before it goes in the oven, and this is after it goes in the oven. Now, if I could ask you for some help spoon a couple of shovelfuls in here.
No problem.
For me, and then we can get started on making this soup.
I'll hold that for you. And I think it's interesting you put the spices on before you roasted it. You didn't wait until after you were done to put it into the soup.
That's right, because as this cooks, those spices also change in their flavor, and they meld with the caramelization. That's fine, Erin.
Mm-hmm.
Thank
okay.
you. The flavors meld with the sugars inside the butternut squash, and that's really a wonderful flavor, and that's what we're after with this roasted butternut squash. Another shortcut that I used was the microwave. You could put this on the stovetop. What's in here is a combination of the chicken stock and the fat-free half and half. Mm-hmm. I microwaved it, and that's where my heat comes from the soup. You could even take this right out of the refrigerator from last night's dinner and have a hot soup on your table, and as long as it takes to get this liquid component boiling.
Okay, I see.
So
yeah.
That's a great tip.
Yeah.
So I put it into this glass bowl. I'm just going to pour it right here, and I'm not going to pour all of it because I'm not sure how much liquid I need for
right.
this. Okay?
And how thick you might want it, I guess. I mean, you're making a bisque, but if someone wants it a little bit thicker, they wouldn't have to put in as much liquid, I guess, right?
Yeah, I like it rustic where it's a little bit thicker.
Mm-hmm.
But so I'll save a little bit of this. I might need it later. I might not.
Okay.
Very important here, Erin, is to cover this up because it can be dangerous, especially with hot liquids. It actually can be like a bomb. So
okay.
always remember to cover that up.
All right, Jason, we're out of time. I know you finished it off with some roasted pine nuts and it looks
yes.
delicious over there. Thanks so much for sharing this with
Thank
us.
You
appreciate it. And
yep.
we'll be right back.
Yeah.